Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for a regular Judas run. That's right. We're going to be playing Judas today just because I felt like playing him. And he's a fun character to learn a bunch of things about. But before we do that, yesterday's video did not cross 5,000 likes. However, the previous videos did, which puts us at 176 over 180 for the like streak. And all Beast Week is looking like it's going to be shaping up to start on Sunday if we keep the likes going. So thank you very much for those of you who do go back and retroactively like those videos. It only takes a second. And even if you don't watch the videos, if you just simply click the like button, that's more than enough support for the channel, and I really do appreciate it. Here's your meme of the day, artwork of the day, or maybe even craft of the day, maybe even all three, to be honest. Title of the thread was, here's the still image of the video, sad I can't post it in both in one, but this is the amazing art piece. This is actually a disc golf disc submitted by LuckyDies777 on Reddit. He also has an Instagram, LuckyDiedG, over on Instagram. I'll put a link down below to his Instagram. Made this amazing Sinvicta custom disc golf disc, which I actually have talked to him about. He's actually doing me the great honor of sending this to me so I can display it in the office. So thank you very much, LuckyDies777. If you want to go check out the video, there's actual video of him twirling this, and it's animated, and Sissy like does barrel rolls. It is hilarious and also incredible. Go on the Sinvicta subreddit, go check it out for yourself, and thank you again, Lucky Dies. Seriously, that is one of the most incredible pieces of fan art I have ever seen. I can honestly say I've never had a disc golf disc made for me, and I would never use it to play, but I'm definitely going to use it to display in the office. CJ is going to be Delta 2-0 Papa Yankee Bravo 8 Romeo. So, regular Judas, my boy Judas. One of my favorite characters in the entire game. He has multiple reasons why. He is amazing. Starting off with the Book of Belial, always great. Starting off with great damage, starting off with good tiers, decent movement speed, all the whole nine yards, the whole shebang. Obviously, the biggest danger with Judas is the fact that he does only start with one HP, but as I was saying in the opening monologue here, this is one of the best strengths of him when it comes to new players. If you find yourself wanting to get good at the game, then Judas is definitely one of those characters that is he's a fantastic training character is what I like to call him. The reason why that is because obviously you do start off with the low life, you know, and Judas' stats are more than enough to carry you through the early game stages here without too many problems, but you do have to put yourself in a good dodging position, unlike what I just did right there. And you find yourself in it's you know, if you want to almost like a, in a weird way, he's kind of like a low life simulator. Like you see in a lot of my videos where we go, you know, towards the end game here, because we took a lot of devil deals, or we took like, you know, we took a lot of bad damage or anything like that. Judas will give you that sort of, that sense of we could die at any time here. So I got to play like lights out. I got to play out of my mind. And that's what Judas is really, really, really good at. Because he's so powerful, he also exemplifies the concept that I've talked about for years and years and years on this channel, which is that your damage keeps you safe. Your damage is your lifeline. Your damage is what will ultimately carry you through an entire run, and it will protect you from taking damage. He is the best example of that, and this is why, you know, I say, you know, training, if you want to train on Isaac, you know, playing as the Lost definitely gives you that same sort of mentality, is that same sort of concept, but you're always like, you know, one hit from dying. Judas, on the other hand, you can always get better. You're not limited to just simply one little HP or one little hit and then you're dead. And, you know, and Judas is just, he's just fun to play. You know, the Lost is also fun to play as well, but the Judas is a little bit more forgiving. And that's really where he takes the concept of damage keeps you safe to the next level. And that's what I really, really, really enjoy about him. So if you want to get better at the game, play Judas. If you want to train at the game, play Judas. If you want to get good at the game, play Judas. Judas will, yes, he will. His damage will act as a crutch for you early on. You can ball out of control really quick, but you know, you also have the increased chance of getting devil deals because of the Book of Belial. So all in all, Judas is just an absolute blast to play, and you should always train on Judas if you are trying to get better at the game. So we start out here with Montezuma's Revenge, which is again one of my, I'm fine with that. Unfortunately, we end up getting Dad's Key, which is going to give us luck, or Dad's coin rather, but it gives us a luck upgrade, but yeah, no stats except for range, I guess. So Seriously, go check out that video that Lucky Dies posted on the Sinvicta subreddit, because it is really, really awesome. When I saw it, I thought I was like, is this Blender or something? Like, what the heck's going on here? Because it doesn't look real, but it's real. It's a real disc, and it's really amazing, is what it is. And I'm looking forward to getting it here and being able to put it up in the office. I need to find like a Lazy Susan frame or something where it would just spin constantly. Although that would probably get annoying and probably cost a lot of batteries. So maybe I shouldn't do that. But it's definitely going to be a centerpiece for the fan art section that I'm building out in my office. And once I'm done with that, like, I'll take pictures and all that stuff and post it for you all. We have Fool's Gold here and another golden chest, which gives us a decent amount of coins here. Montezuma's Revenge is going to give us a Brimstone-esque type damaging beam tier effect, whatever you want to call it, along that fires out a bunch of corn as well. And it's an unwieldy item, but if you can manage to tame the beast and actually gain control of Montezuma's Revenge, you'll be treated with essentially what is a more powerful Brimstone than you could get right out of the gate. Because it combines the damage of the constant beam of damage with the additional physical damage from the corn shots. And it's just a fantastic item. If you get used to controlling it, it is so good. We'll get Dirty Mind here, which is going to give us two or three for oh crap. There's also the mystery gift in there, which we could potentially use for the secret room or the devil deal or the angel deal. We've got a lot of options right now. So even though it looks like I'm doing a pretty good job at controlling Montezuma's Revenge, you're like, how can this be hard? The thing is that Montezuma's Revenge kind of it goes in the opposite direction of where you're going. So if you want it to fire upward, in other words, you need to be moving backwards. So it takes a little bit of getting used to it. When you do, man, oh man, it shreds. We get another golden chest, which, I mean, hey, I appreciate a game and all, but if we can just get like some soul hearts, that'd be cool. I don't trust this room at all. There we go. I'm going to take the bomb here. Let's go fight the boss real quick. It's going to be Ragman. I'm going to instantly pop the Book of Belial, and then this should... Oh, it's Champion Ragman, too. Yeah, we destroyed his head instantly. It's a little bit tougher to aim Montezuma's Revenge here. A little bit tougher to aim Monster's Revenge at an angle like that. I will go check here, and we are not going to be able to get that, unfortunately. We can take Pogatory, though. I wouldn't mind Pogatory. Yeah, I think we take Pogatory. Purgatory is going to give us a fissure on the ground, which will allow us to send out one of those. Ooh, my goodness. Thank you very much, game. It's going to allow us to send out those exploding spirits that you see me, that I'm a big, big fan of. Secret room might be here. I don't think it is. Yeah. This is a tough one here. Okay. Cannot be there. So it could be here. That's the most likely spot, I'm guessing. Could also be there. I have a feeling it's... I mean, we only get one shot at this, so I have a feeling it's here. Yeah. Okay. Oh, my goodness. And we do get a reroll machine, but the problem now is that we don't have enough money to reroll our mystery gift. We have one reroll remaining with a bomb, essentially, and that's it. I think we're going to go for the big time play and go for broke here. And let's just see if we can maybe get something good. I wouldn't mind an early R key here. Get the Necronomicon, which I suppose we'll take. I mean, Lump of Coal was good there, but we get two or three for the Bookworm. I decided not to bomb it just because we only have one bomb and it might roll through something that we actually want, and then I could be really, really sad. On top of that, it's our only bomb. So I'm fine with the Bookworm Touch. Obviously, I would have, like, it's not going to reroll again off of 1 cent. That's just not going to happen. We got super lucky that even happened one time. Yeah, and I don't know exactly where our super secret room is. Oh, actually, I do. Well, it's a 50-50. It's either going to be here or here. Part of me wants to say it's here. And it is. Okay. And boy, howdy, was that worth it. All right. So we do get the deal with the devil precedent. Very, very long two first floors here, but we had a lot of backtracking to do. So you see the animation there. It does give us the Eternal Heart. Which will, of course, give us the HP upgrade, which is so, so important on Judas. Montezuma's Revenge is going to keep us safe as well, as long as we don't get too greedy with our positioning. There's Pogatory. There's a charge key there, which I probably will just take because I'm going to forget about it. Purgatory, there's the fissure. It's kind of hard to see on the flooded caves. There we go. Another nice little property there, Purgatory, one that I mentioned a lot. I don't know if other people talk about it, but the fact that Purgatory cancels out the projectile death rattles from enemies after you kill them is really, really nice. Our fourth key here. Yeah, we could probably do this. I'm going to go ahead and pop the Book of Belial now. I thought that was a troll bomb for a second. I couldn't tell. Now, we do not have to specifically use Montezuma's Revenge as our main source of damage. If anything, it gives us more secondary damage that we can deal without us having to really... Well, I was a little bit too close for comfort there. Without us really having to reposition that much, but you do have to be careful, especially with these dark grubs here, because they can do the death rattle, which will, you know, cause you lots of problems. We still don't have a bomb, but we have 6 keys now. Gonna wait for Montezuma's Revenge to charge. I watched that tier, and my mind was like, oh, do we want to dodge it? Do we want to dodge it, or should we follow it? Do we dodge it? Follow it? Okay, follow it. And then we just ran right into it like an idiot. Nice infection. It's too good to reroll. Okay. We actually probably don't want to increase our Devil Deal chance right now, because we can't really afford... take a devil deal unless we get another HP upgrade, which even then doesn't guarantee that we're going to be able to take it. Super secret room should be here. Hopefully there's like 2 eternal hearts in here. Okay, well, there's money. Not a lot to really... getting a bind over, but hopefully we can get a couple of soul hearts on the next floor. There's a Book of Belial here again, just to boost our damage. You see how effective Montezuma's Revenge is at just dealing with super easy to hit enemies here. And we'll take a range upgrade. No deal with the devil. I'm honestly fine with that. And we'll head on down. You might be asking yourself, why would you be fine with missing a devil deal for once, Invicta? Well, the reason being is because even if we do get a devil deal on that floor, we can't take it. We have to, once again, rely upon us getting either soul hearts as a way of like a secondary measure of picking up like a passive item that grants soul hearts, or extra lives, or transformation. Otherwise, we can't take it. So it is in our best interest to say, you know what, let's not take the devil deal here. Let's try to get some more HP on the next floor and then try to cash in a devil deal that way. They may have noticed that I do fall into the very similar trap of me using Maw of the Void, me using orbitals back in the day, et cetera, et cetera. Of me wanting to prioritize an unnecessarily risky maneuver just to use an item that we don't need to do. We don't need to use Montezuma's Revenge. I'm just impatient and I like dealing lots of damage to things. But we don't have to is the thing. So don't, it's a really, really difficult force of habit to break. But if you can, try not to do that. There's no reason for us to be put into the situation that I'm putting myself in constantly by forcing the issue and using Montezuma's Revenge. We don't have to. But because I have it, my brain is like, dude, we could be killing these rooms a lot faster. I'm just happy that we got a champion down here. Yes, there was a flying anus monster meme that was already made on the Sinvicta subreddit, so if you're thinking about making one, don't worry, it's already been done. That'd be a greed fight. Purgatory gonna help us out here. There we go. Good hit by Purgatory, taking down not only greed, but the two leapers that he spawned as well. Not an ideal scenario with the greed fight being in a shop that we really, really, really needed to get a soul heart out of, or two, or 10, or 20. Just blast him down with Montezuma's Revenge. Now, Loki's Horns, I believe that it will also proc with Montezuma's Revenge, I think. I think it gives you multi-directional Montezuma's Revenge, which sounds like a really bad trip to a bad bad restaurant. I think it does. I'm not 100% sure on that. It'd be a great band name, though. Multi-directional Montezuma's Revenge. I'd buy their album. No, we do not need any kind of meme of the day for that. I'm good, thank you. We've had so many good artworks of the day. I mean, it's just like I was saying the other day on the channel. You know, I really wish that I could feature like 30 memes of the day, but that's all the video would be. And we have so many talented artists in the mosh pit that create, like, some of them create daily pieces of art. For no reason at all, just to show their love and support for the channel and everything, and that just blows my mind, man. And I don't want to discourage people from doing stuff like that, but obviously I gotta spread the love around, you know. So we do get our devil deal. Unfortunately, we don't get an HP upgrade. We do get Death's List and Gimpy. I think we got to go with Death's List here. As much as I like Gimpy, I think the Death's List makes a little bit more sense. So we're playing really, really, really close to the chest right now. We got to be super careful. Death's List, of course, is going to give us a skull, which is going to appear above enemies in the room. And if you kill the enemies in that order that the skull appears, you will get a variety of awesome benefits, which could include soul hearts and stat ups and all kinds of good stuff. I'd hate to say that it's one of my signature items, but people do tend to associate Death's List with me just because I explain it every single time it shows up. Become kind of a meme. And there you go, Deathless giving us a big soul heart right there. Huge soul heart for us. It's big time plays, Deathless. Big time plays. Deathless is a big time player. So, what's the golden rule about Deathless? Don't force the issue. Do not. Oh, look at that. We get a 1 damage upgrade. Good lordy. Good lordy. We still get 2 item rooms, so I guess this is worth it. I feel like I want to save this stars. No, let's go. Let's use the stars card now because we can go get the fool card on the next floor. Look, and we get another soul heart. Oh my goodness. Yeah, what's the biggest number one rule about Death's List? Don't force the issue. Do not try to get Death's List to pay out if it's going to mean that you're going to take a hit. It's not worth it. It is just simply not worth it. And I am very guilty of doing that, of doing the exact opposite of that. Do as I say, not as I do. How to jump, and we also get Book of Shadows, which I am going to take over the Book of Belial. That completes our Bookworm transformation as well. We just got a whole squad of just Dookie behind us in way more ways than one, which I don't really like. Now, obviously, Death's List is a little bit dangerous. Not dangerous. It's a little bit wonky to deal with because, obviously, if you have a lot of adds or if you have multi-shots or anything like that, you're going to most likely not get Death's List to pay out. So think of Death's List as like just an extra little added bonus giver. Sometimes it will give you a stat up. Sometimes it give you some soul hearts or two or, you know, two and a half. Careful now. But for the most part, you know, Death's List is there to support you. It is a very strong carry support item, and it can carry you. I'm going to immediately pop the Book of Shadows in here, and then we're just going to wreck Brownie. Thank goodness Monsieur's Revenge doesn't do something stupid like heal Brownie. Experimental treatment, no thank you. So the golden question mark that we picked up in the store will give us a second item room. We got a tears up from that. There we go. It gives us a second item room pedestal that we can choose from in only our item rooms. But it's always good just to have more options. Oh, I don't know how we didn't take a hit there. That was real close. You know, Purgatory. You see the little red fissure on the ground there. I actually popped the Book of Shadows deliberately here because I don't trust the Eggles along with the with all the dips kind of floating about. The dips have this weird thing where they act kind of like bumper cars and they just kind of launch things in undesirable locations. Okay, there's our fool card. If we hurry, we can make it. We can make the boss rush if we hurry. We have to be going the right way right now, though. The D sizzle. Oh my goodness gracious. As I live and breathe. And we went the wrong way. Hey, see what I'm talking about? You saw how it kind of jostled Monstro there. How did that not kill you? I had an itch. Apologies. My nose is itching. It's better that I itch my nose than sneeze, I promise. I don't know how we ended up getting Death's List out of that, but we did. He says we got 30 seconds. We might be able to make it into the boss rush if we hurry. Oh, we got to skip that. We can come back there and get that. Oh, wow. This is Red Mom. I didn't realize it. Actually works out for us with Monsieur's Revenge. Oh, come on. There we go. I'm going to go for boss rush because we have the D6. We get the wafer abso-freaking-lutely. Whew. Okay, that was a little bit dangerous there. I had to choose real quick because if I had gone into the devil deal, then we would have not made boss rush. Wow, we get a black soul heart just for no reason at all. Looking for a full charge. We're not going to get it. Wouldn't mind getting more HP from this judgment here. Seeker might be here. So this is one of those dumb rooms where you kind of have to make a path and then just kind of like do this. So it's kind of annoying because we can't really like, you can't stay next to the judgment because he could give you like that, like he could just slingshot you off. And you also have to worry about the troll bombs. Well, he gave us that, so it doesn't matter anymore. Unless if we double, bro, are you serious? We got knocked into the spikes thanks to the spike rocks. Okay, so that's what I was wanting to do. I really, really hope that we can hope and pray one day that we'll get a patch that makes it to where item pedestals don't just launch you from picking stuff up. Dude, come on, Dips. You gotta work with me here. That dip just guided that Mask of Infamy right towards us. Which is kind of the reason why, like, I don't usually pick up Dirty Mind, except this is one time where, like, we almost had the old... It was right after Montezuma's Revenge, so, like, we almost had the oh crap transformation, like, right out the gate, which is one that you don't see all that often. It's really the only reason why I picked up Dirty Mind. I think that Dirty Mind's actually not that great. Respond to Host here. Just randomly, thanks to Pogatory. Well, thanks to Pogatory getting the hit on the bomb fly. So, are we going to be able to get a full charge? It looks like we might. I think it would be neat if they wanted to buff Purgatory, which I'm not trying to say that that Purgatory requires a buff or anything, but if they were, if Ed and Vin were to buff Purgatory, I would love to see them make it to where it turns into, instead of Isaac walking over it, it could be Isaac or like a landmine, like tripwire sort of mechanic, where if an enemy crosses the Purgatory fissure, it thereby launches the attack. I think that would be pretty awesome. You know, because then you imagine being in a big room and there's like multiple Purgatory fissures everywhere, and it's just being triggered left and right because the enemy's just passing over it over and over and over again. That would be really cool. Yeah, we get Luckfoot and Bursting Sack. I'd say that's a pretty good play there. You know, we didn't really have any aspirations of taking the Book of Shadows with us anymore after we saw the D6. So I'm perfectly fine with that. We end up getting the wafer out of the boss rush, which was even cooler because obviously the wafer is going to give us even more HP as we head on down towards the second half of this run. Yeah, that's a big time floor right there. So the wafer will give us essentially what is double HP. These floors here, from here on out, that we take a full heart of damage. Whenever we do take damage from the womb and beyond, is going to get turned down into a half heart of damage here. We get back-to-back stat upgrades. One was the luck. One was the shot speed. Secret room might be there. We've got eight bombs. Might as well try. Ooh, baby. All right, so we do have a secret room item pedestal here with the D-Sizzle. You know what that means. We're going to be looking for a couple rerolls, and yeah. Get a nickel for our troubles. This also might be the super secret room. No. Okay. Item pedestal in the secret room. Wha-bam. So we're going to keep looking for a full charge here. Now, you might be asking yourself, Victor, what about empty rooms like this? Does Desolus work? Yes, actually it does. Desolus works fantastically in those free rooms. Is this an invisible an invisible doppelganger. I don't think I've seen one of those before. Oh, here you go. Enjoy. Take it easy on ourselves here. Loki's horns is going to make it pretty difficult in multi-enemy rooms to be able to get the Deathless payout. Just gonna wait for him to fly over here. Yep. We could go down to Polar Invincibility here, and might even get ourselves. Well, I was gonna say we might could. Get ourselves a an HP upgrade. But that did not happen. Got another luck upgrade. So I'm going to be super lazy because I don't feel like going around. And we get Mystery Sack. All right. And Schmabulous. So because we're on a half heart of HP now, we have activated Polar Invincibility, which means that we will get a Book of Shadows-esque type invincibility shield every time we take damage now, until that HP regenerates or we accidentally walk into a heart. Pretty cool how Diglett's can just spawn on top of the Purgatory Fissure, which happened to be right underneath us. That was pretty cool. Still looking for Tinted Rocks. Not seeing any. Fan of seeing Gertie Jr. here. Luckily, the dips will give us kind of a wall of damage here. We do get a Tears Up from Death's List again. Alright, and this is definitely going to be the last reroll that we have here on this floor. Come on, D6. You know what? Keybum, come on. Today, you're not a total joke. You're just a part joke. We've got 17 keys. We might as well, you know? It's very odd that they started off with 6 adds instead of 4 in this room. Science Infection making the big time plays. All right, and we get Marrow. Awesome Possum. Yeah, so we do get a Demon Judgment, which I am going to play. I mean, it just gets us back down to Polar Invincibility pretty much immediately. And we get Black Powder, which I do not want. But it does afford us an opportunity to reroll something. And we can actually get another Item Pedestal here out of this Judgment. I would take a regular HP upgrade. But if we get something crappy like Portable Slot or something, then I can just re-roll it. Or a little chest. I mean, a little chest is not crappy necessarily, but it's not good either. I mean, we have 5 luck, so that's the reason why we're just getting nothing but the Item Pedestal. Unfortunately, it doesn't help you win any better. Okay, I just wanted to fill the Bone Heart. Bone Heart's going to be very, very, very important when it comes to us having the wafer. I mean, I'd be thrilled if we got Scatole here. Sorry, Keybum. I'm so used to not taking you that I don't even notice you. Okay, give us a golden chest. We potentially could get four item pedestals out of this one room. And with the D6, that's pretty pog. You might be wondering what I'm still playing, like what would I need money for? It's to play this three skull Monty. So we can get the more possibility of us getting an item pedestal out of here. Are you a coin? We have five luck. Apparently the game does not care for our luck. There's only one luck that it cares about, and that's Invicta luck. Get more moolah here. I mean, we have the potential for even more item pedestals, really, if Keybum gives us a chest that gives us, like, an item pedestal. Still no payout from Scatola yet. Okay, game. Pretty sure that fly was launched there by a dip. I heard a dip die right as that fly spawned, so. Hey, look at that. We got a soul heart here. I tell you what. We will not leave this room until we get Scatole. So how long it takes us to get their game is up to you. That's what I thought. Okay, so we've got three with the possibility of four item pedestals in that one room to re-roll through with the D-Sizzle. And that's got me pretty excited. Hey. It's the first time I've seen a golden doorstop. Got a movement speed upgrade. I swear to God, I didn't see that was a mimic chest. Excuse me. Justice card, hermit card. Reverse Justice card is going to give us four chests, which you already know what I'm going to do with these. Well, two to four chests anyway. It's probably going to be two. As I was saying. So right now we're just playing for the full charges and nothing else really. Because obviously I think we can do a lot better than Black Powder and whatever else we had in there. The doorstop is going to keep the doors open for us. So if we do happen to go in the wrong direction, we can just nope on out of there. But again, we're playing for the full charges here. We're not playing for mapping. Getting a lot of money out of this. The D-Wizzle. Excuse me. Apparently I've never seen this room before. Apparently these two statues just fire at you immediately as soon as you walk through the door. Yeah, good luck getting Deathless in here. Just be happy if you escape this room without taking damage. Okay. Let's keep it going here. Let's try to soften the blow of taking too much damage. We do have the wafer, but that doesn't mean that we're invincible. Not happy with the amount of damage we've taken here, although admittedly some of the damage has been pretty sus. Get another movement speed upgrade here. The combination of the dips launching stuff and that mimic chest. Fortunately, these double hearts are a day late and a dollar short of saving our bone heart. You get a soul heart, and there's also a mini charge here. So let's go back into... I'm just going to save myself the time. I don't feel like walking back here. I think Libra is a bad idea. In this case. You all know that I love me some Libra. But in this regard, I do think that it is not a good idea. We could use the Hermit card to get out of the curse room. Unless if I would have to go into the boss trap room and actually do it in order for us to possibly get another full charge on this floor, which I don't think is going to happen. But Libra in this regard would definitely be a bad idea. Yeah, we don't care about Envy in here. Whoop. We'll take Shoop. Wait a second. Do we have two? Oh, you know what? We will have one more reroll. Thanks to this mini charge. We'll have one more reroll. We take the mini charge and we also fight Mom's Heart. That will give us another full charge on the D6, which lines up perfectly here with the Devil Deal, assuming that we get one, which we probably won't. Purgatory is excellent versus Mom's Heart. See here, just cancels out all those shots, making it a lot safer for us. We get Science Infection going. We do get a deal with the devil, which is surprising, and it's a Krampus fight. She gave us the head of Krampus. I'm actually not going to reroll the head of Krampus. The reason being is because we just have more item pedestals down in the arcade. Even though I know I just got done saying I don't feel like walking all the way back there, this is worth it. For us to have one more reroll, I'm gonna take it. Because don't let our HP and our current standing like fool you right now. Like, we are very easily overwhelmed, even with the wafer. Take boom, and I think that might be it. Don't know what this card is. We're about to find out. World card. Party time. Excellent.
Pheromones.
Ooh. Okay. I'm down with that. And I'm super stoked to be having the doorstop with us. I'm doing this just to get rid of our red heart. Just so we have polar invincibility, as it is very, very vital. And after a super duper long womb too. Hey, but we were making plays though. Like it was, this floor was long, but only because we had to do a lot of backtracking and it's like ridiculously huge. Super secret room might be here as well. And we get an eternal heart, which does ruin our polar invincibility, but that's fine. We get more HP. That's all that matters. Okay, so I'm going to use the world card here, and there is a secret room right next to us, so you know what? Rather not. This is only slightly better, and we still got hit anyway. Excuse me? Oh, I didn't even see that guy over there. Speed up.
Speed up.
Unlike Mercurius, we can't go through rooms that we haven't cleared already, but we can back out of rooms that are in the wrong direction now. Obviously, we use a world card here, so we won't go in the wrong direction. Although that's never stopped us before, let's be honest. Hate that this eye is still alive. That's the one that makes you small pill. We do get our soul heart back at least. Professional booth will take us down to polar invincibility again, which is going to be nice against Isaac. Could also give us a soul heart. Hey, look at that. And it gave us an angel deal chance too, which obviously doesn't exist anymore, but yeah, play those confessional booths. You never know what you might get. And charge up Montezuma's Revenge, and we're ready to go for the showdown here against Isaac. That was an amazing shot by Isaac. I cracked the skizzle there. I don't know how he calculated that we were going to be right there at that exact moment. Get our soul heart back, and we're ready to go. Last two levels, I think, took longer than like all the other floors combined. All right, now thanks to the D6, we can re-roll whatever we get in here, which is all garbage, and still pretty garbage. I will use the Book of Secrets just to maybe give us some mapping. Yeah, there we go. Double Super Gluttony. He's pretty easy getting the pretty easy getting the payout for. We get Twanky Twanky. It's gonna destroy our damage, but it gives us another shot, which, you know, it's still like 2020, the jury's still out on whether or not it's worth still picking up or not. I'd say it is. Okay, the reason why I was running there is because I was gonna try to get away from Key Bum. If he did decide to drop a chest, we might be able to put it back in that other one with the that other room with all the pedestals and stuff. Purgatory, you okay? This room here is just hold on for your dear life. Just hope that Montezuma's Revenge can get you out of it. There we go. Okay, look, Key Beggar, I'm gonna be honest. You've taken like 7 keys in a row now without paying out. Need you to step it up, son. You were brought up here for one specific reason, and that reason was giving us chests. Okay, as you continue to do so, you're not doing what you're supposed to be doing, which is giving us chests. That only serves to annoy me. So what I need you to do, and I need you to listen real close here, kid. What I need you to do is I need you to take the keys that drop on the ground and give us chests. You not doing that only serves to waste my time and just annoy me. Can you do that for me, son? I know your brother's on the team and all. You know, I know that D Bizzle's here. Well, he's not here with us, but I know that he's on the roster. Don't think that you're subjected to any kind of special treatment here. On the contrary, you being his brother means that you're going to receive the same, if not even more. I don't know how we end up getting Desolus out of that, but we did. Now, obviously, I mean, we could destroy Blue Baby now at this point, but I'm just going for the rerolls. See what else we can get. You never know. Might get a Phantom Arky. Maybe a Dad's Kizzle. You never know. God. Is that Black Pin? It is. Finger. You know, sometimes items are just so bad that even when we're winning, I still don't even want them. The finger is not one of those items. Finger can be good. Sometimes it's not. It really depends on your build. But sometimes it can be good. However, Bloodshot Eye is just, like, not that super great. It's not horrible, necessarily, but... Here come all the... Get ready for the Bloodshot Eye stands. They're be coming out of left field. It's my favorite item in the world. It has 3,000 applicable advantages, and I'm going to list them all for you, starting with A. Okay. I think one more reroll and we're good. Keybum did give us Ghost Pepper here, which obviously is a fan-schmabulous item. Big time fan of that. See, the thing is our shot speed is so high now that we're actually to the point where we're knocking enemies back. It's making it kind of difficult for us to land Montezuma's Revenge. Belly button is going to allow us to pick up a second trinket. Hookworm, I don't think we'll really need. Yeah, I'm trying to do my due diligence here and stay away from red hearts. Brownie just gave us a whole lot of a whole lot of dips to our arsenal. Telekinesis, very good item. Yeah, Freezer Baby's not bad. Finally get a damage upgrade. It was reduced by 25%, as you can see there, with thanks to 2020. And I think that'll do it. So thank you for watching, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this episode of The Binding of Isaac Repentance. It was a great Judas run. We did have to do a little bit of work, honestly, to make it happen, but it got a little bit dicey at the end, but you know what, it was definitely worth it at the end of the day. We made a lot of friends along the way, and you got to see how awesome it is. With these schmoobs, you got to see how awesome it is to have Montezuma's Revenge from the get-go. Super powerful item. It does magic for you if you can control it. So definitely play this seed if you want to get not only practice with Judas, but also of course with Montezuma's Revenge. See how awesome the item is for yourself. And thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing, everyone. Have a great start to your Wednesday. Don't forget to check out my Twitch stream here on, not here, but over at twitch.tv/Sinvicta. And thank you again, everyone, for liking the videos. I really appreciate it. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Cole Rhodes, David Scott, Ty Kirk, Willow of the Wisps, and Kaizo Blades. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.